What happens at Windows 10 end of support? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a common question I'm hearing increasingly as the Windows 10 end of support date nears. Will Windows 10 keep working after its end of support? Can I keep using it? Or will Microsoft force me to upgrade to Windows 11? No, you won't be forced to upgrade. You can keep using it. It's important to understand the risks involved. One thing we've learned from being here before is that the risks may not be as horrific as some make them out to be. Windows 10, 22H2, will be supported until October the 14th, 2025. The only thing that happens when support ends is that no further fixes are available, even for security-related issues. In fact, even now, as the date draws closer, security-related issues are the only fixes you're getting. It will keep working, but whatever Windows 10 looks like on October the 14th is exactly what it will be from then on. No changes, no fixes, no nothing. Now, for the first time, Microsoft is making extended security updates available to consumers who use Home and Pro editions. Sort of. Quoting their website, "And for the first time ever, we're introducing an ESU program for personal use as well. The ESU program for consumers will be a one-year option available for $30. Program enrollment will be available closer to the end of support in 2025. So, yeah, for $30, you get 1 year of additional security updates beyond the October 14th, 2025 cutoff date. 1 year. After that, you're once again on your own. Essentially, you've simply punted the deadline 1 year further down the field. Now, just because Windows stops getting updates doesn't mean that the applications you use will stop getting updates. That depends entirely on the application vendor and when they decide to stop supporting Windows 10. Some may stop on Microsoft's date. Others may stop sometime thereafter. You simply need to monitor updates for the programs you care about. Someday, yep, those updates will probably stop as well. It'll be up to you to decide if you care. Windows Security, on the other hand, will in fact get some updates for some time. I tend to think of it as separate from Windows itself. It has its own deadline, if you will. Just as if it were a third-party application, the scanner will continue to get updates for some time. The database of malware that it relies on will continue to be updated as well. Security bugs in Windows itself will not be fixed, but the security software looking for malware will stay current for some unspecified time. So, what's the risk? That's a great question. The gloom and doom scenario is that there's an unpatched vulnerability waiting to be found. Hackers will exploit it and Microsoft won't fix it. The more pragmatic risk is that eventually your other software will no longer be supported. You'll have to figure out whether you can live with it or find alternatives. The other risk is that when your computer dies, you won't be able to get Windows 10 for its replacement. Once again, you'll face a decision. Move to the latest, most current version of Windows, or switch to something else entirely. Perhaps the most important step the keeping yourself safe is to make extra sure you're following proper security practices and that your security software continues to work and continues to be updated. If your security software is no longer supported, find an alternative immediately. Like I said, Windows Security should continue to receive updates for a while. In the past, Windows security software continued to be updated for quite a time, actually, after Windows itself was past end of support. The other important step I recommend is my old standby, regular and complete backups. If something goes wrong, you'll want to restore to a backup. This will also protect you to some extent when Microsoft eventually takes existing Windows 10 updates and activation offline. That action would prevent you from downloading Windows 10 from scratch, but if you have a backup, you can still restore it. If what we're experiencing sounds perhaps hauntingly familiar, that's because it is. This is exactly what happened with Windows 7 some years ago, and even Windows XP before it. And in the light of many dire predictions of catastrophe and doom, nothing happened. There were no catastrophic malware outbreaks targeting Windows 7 or Windows XP. There was no list of known vulnerabilities that hackers kept secret until they knew they wouldn't be fixed. Nothing. Windows 7, Vista, and XP users were probably more affected by decreasing hardware and software support for the applications they cared about. I expect Windows 10's death to be very similar, a slow fade into obscurity. If you're running Windows 10, yeah, it's time to at least start thinking about Windows 11 if you can. But even if you don't, as long as you continue to use your computer safely, you should be fine. Eventually, yeah, you'll want to upgrade, either because the software you care about stops working, or you get a new machine with a new version of Windows pre-installed. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/145971. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.